Thank you. 把它传播给大众，让大众更能深刻的和正确的去认识它。然后我们对做同样的改变，可能用在在欢乐和乐趣上面，而且我觉得它可以改变我们对生活的态度，就是你要去坚持和做一些与众不同的这样一些东西。Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. this is a little bit better. I don't really know. All right, now we're gonna season this thing, maybe. It's cold, so I gotta get my flannel stitched up. Let's see how totally wild my hair face is from that mask. See, I got mask face. What I got? Hair is definitely big. Not too much dust on my face, so I like that. Nice. Now Joel's making fun of me for the Tyvek suit, but I love it. I love Tyvek so much. Big hair, don't care is right. There we go. Okay. All right. Propane. Yeah. That's right. So this thing is already rusting because it took off all the coating. Squirt bottle of oil. Oh yeah, can flash rust. So there's some metals that are real susceptible to oxidation. And this one is very much of that. I'm gonna go get my grab something from inside. Yeah, you can see a little bit on here. You can see some of the orange on the paper towel. That's rust that was already forming. So I'm gonna leave this very hot thing running for just a moment. I'm gonna run inside. You guys keep an eye on it, okay? Let me know if anything goes wrong. Basically, we just get this thing like hella hot. We get to smoke. I'm quite pleased with this. smooth. Kind of just wait. Kind of a good joke of like, watch a man cook nothing. Yeah. Yes, sirree. This is a $9 cast iron griddle from Walmart. And you can see it's starting to smoke a little bit. That's exactly what we want. Although, to be honest, I wish it was a little bit more even. You can see there's some circles here, kind of hot spots. Meaning it's not really distributing the heat too well, so this could be something better done in an oven or a grill. But I don't really want to. So I'm not gonna. Bummed out, your internet's still fighting you, Griddles. It's no fun. Wow, look how direct that heat is. It's quite the hot spot we got. I'm gonna shift this just a little bit to the side here. Good note, when it's smoking like this, if there is an excess of oil, just catch fire. You don't really want an excess of oil, you just kind of want it to smoke away. Problems that we're going to experience with this uneven heating is that it may warp. My incessant neighborhood dogs. That's nice. They never stop. Ever. Those bastards. Hey there, Zen Haver. Some lo-fi dogs. This thing around. Gosh, this whole contraption is hot. I'm gonna try and get some heat right here. So, I bought a big pack of Swiss Miss like a week and a half ago. There's too much of it gone already, you guys. I've been hitting that hot cocoa hard. I had it in every cup of coffee. It's bad. But it's so good. I love it so much. I am in love with the cocoa. Start this other burner. That's a chance to cool a little bit. What's the goal here? We want it all black. So, in more of the technicality terms, we are forming some polymerization. We're burning the oil in a way, in these thin layers, where it's going to create a nice layer of some non-stick that's going to hopefully not flake off the food. Now we can actually put this more exactly over the burner that we want. Yeah. I just about have my respirator still on. I'm gonna do it. Can't drink coffee. It's coated in oil, so it's just frying. Breathe in the smoke instead. Smoke ain't so bad. So we're applying lots of thin layers here. I'm using peanut oil right now. This stem thing is so cheap. It's extremely warped, like out of the factory. Yeah, just like a normal streamer Zen Haver. You just gotta gotta make some sacrifices. You can see little bits of it are coming off. It's like kind of starting to disintegrate. Explain the timeline better. Alright, so I don't know if I can. I'll quick show you the bottom side. Ready? So this is the bottom side. See how it's like kind of looks more gritty? So I evened all that out and polished it. Coating so that it does not rust. I Yeah, this is a new purchase. This was the $9 I was unsupervised and it was on sale griddle. And I got this burner here a couple of weeks ago. I've been planning on being outdoors and camping quite a bit this summer. And I wanted to have a dedicated griddle for it. It does come ready to go, but it's not very non-stick, so I'm glad you asked, Quills. So, in the olden days, cast iron was spun cast and polished in the factory. Nowadays, it is sand casted, which means that they make basically a spot for it in some fine sand and then pour in the cast iron. Molten iron, I should say, to cast it into the correct shape. And so, and what they often do is they say, oh yeah, it's pre-seasoned. And I put this like really bad layer of this like vegetable oil seasoning. That's what we're doing right now is we're seasoning the cast iron. So they put some vegetable oil seasoning on it, on top of the grit from the sand casting without polishing it at all. So a lot of why people don't like cast iron is because it's not very non-stick from the factory. Because it's sand casted and not polished. So if you are looking to buy nice cast iron, a lot of people buy either vintage stuff or the really fancy stuff that is pre-polished, so like a fancy cast iron pan that's polished from the factory is I know it's factory, but I've been watching a YouTuber who says factory, and I really shouldn't do that too often. Like a fancy cast iron pan can cost you like $200. And doing this kind of treatment to it, you're getting as good of a pan, essentially, as some of the really fancy stuff. Maybe not quite so good, but... In fact, my favorite game, Factorio. Yeah, so we're seasoning the cast iron right now by creating a layer of polymerization by heating it too much on the cast iron, and the oil basically goes through a chemical change and binds itself with all the little openings and porous components of the cast iron pan. So, I don't know how long it's been doing that, but this one burner was just like off. Which is not healthy for me to have propane just gathering underneath this thing. Oh yeah. Thanks for stopping in, Goodles, I appreciate it. And yes, Zen have our science. This left side's still too hot. Right here a little bit. Try and get these edges. So my wife is picking up some griddleable food, so I think we might be having some steak or something. She is humoring me on this project, which is nice of her. But this is looking nice. nice. Kind of watch it as you're going through this. You'll see it like looks really dry when the oil has already been fully absorbed. God, that's hot. We're approaching levels of heat where I really should have some tongs or something. These heat gloves aren't really cutting it too well. What was for dinner tonight, Zenhaver? In the Zenhaver household. So, I didn't realize it, but I got these. I got those red hot. Device. Making some fancy steaks and roasted squash tomorrow night. So, frozen pot pie with assorted vegetables. Ooh, yum. You like me some frozen pot pie. Alright, folks. I think this is seasoned. For a little bit. Chuck blade steak. Is that what we should get? lean steak is. Zenever, are you aware of what a blade steak is? So we're thinking about maybe... Ooh, should we make Philly cheesesteaks? That's what we should do. Like a test egg or something? That's a thing people do. Yeah, she's picking up hoagies. What kind of cheese should I grab? Swiss cheese, I think? This too well before I started doing this. Could be maybe just like one piece of grit or something from sandpaper, but I think we should have most of it. Scratch this up, but that's okay. If I wanted to really take the time to do it right, I would do this all in the oven to make the harder polymerization. Oh, but it should be fine. Put away some of the metalworking stuff before I make food. Thanks for stopping by, Zenever. Right. Nice big onion. This thing is looking pretty small right now. So we're going to be cooking on this is a Coleman Classic. camping trip next week, so I want to get some practice cooking on not a kitchen. And I think this is a good way to practice, so we're gonna get this thing started. Definitely feeling like this griddle is a couple inches smaller than the other one. There's a blackstone griddle like 20 feet away from me. It's huge. I really want to get some practice this way. Started. Oh, I didn't realize they were so big. That's awesome.
Can I just grab one?
No, it's going to be great.
How your watch day is. And then can I have your time?
Could you bring out another like bowl or two? Two onions down. o'clock already. Cool. Surprised how late it is. It's definitely smaller than our other griddle.
Yeah.
I've lost a couple onions already.
Oh no.
Nice.
Okay. And it's pretty good.
Nice.
You need butter?
I was just using peanut oil.
Okay.
But we can use butter if we want.
Well, I think we should butter the bread and then
cook. Oh yeah. You want to bring out our freezer butter?
Yeah. Anything else? Grab salt and pepper.
Yeah, that'd be good. I'll just put stuff, once it's done cooking, I'm going to put it on in different bowls, and then I'll pour it back up at the end.
Yeah. Wait, are we still in the video?
Not right away. Oh yeah, bring out a couple of heads of garlic, or cloves of garlic, would be good. Thank you. Yeah. That sounds good. This will be a while, though. Like, at least, like, 30 plus minutes.
Oh, wait a little bit.
Yeah.
Maybe 15?
Yeah. Sounds good.
You have 5 people watching.
Plus, I just sent it to my mom. She can watch it too. And Woody. Oop, there we go, getting some char on these. That's what we want. So, one of my favorite things when cooking on a griddle. And just in general, not losing my onions, but is to have a stick of butter in the freezer. That's just the freezer butter. That stuff's gone. And what you can do is you can just like put it directly onto a hot pan and it melts just a little bit. And, really good for getting things moving on these kinds of, this kind of cookware. Let's cut our green pepper. Get that ready. Next. So I like to cut it this way. My friend Zach taught me how to do that. Marnie, can you get some of the jalapenos from the jar? I think that would be good. It's taking a while, I can tell, because the, bit of a wind, I think, maybe. Pretty protected right here. Oh yeah, that'd be good. I like those a lot. Do you mind cutting those up? Dang it. technique we could do. Pulling stuff kind of forward off the main part of the heat. Cheesesteak kind of stuff tonight. Got some really big, beautiful hoagie buns. The size of these things are huge.
Full subject.
Browning quite nicely. I don't think I've lost one yet, but it's really only a matter of time. Let's get these onions mixed in. Smells awesome. converted fully to a smash and peel man with garlic cloves. No longer am I to have the patience to peel garlic before smashing. It really works a lot better. I'm just going to do kind of a rough cut. Don't have to like really finely dice it. The smash will already be a lot better. We recently got like a huge bag of garlic cloves from Costco. And we've been having like two or three cloves of garlic in like every single meal the last like couple weeks. So, it's hard to do this again with getting this griddle. I would take my time buying one and probably not just get the very cheapest one I possibly can. I mean, it's working really well non-stick wise, but I would get one that is exactly the size of my stove. So, I think what I'm going to do next is the gross part, which is cooking the mushrooms. I don't really like mushrooms. So, but it was a request from my wife who picked up the groceries for this, so it's going to happen. And she's pretty cool, so I'll cook mushrooms for her. Everyone can enjoy the incessant neighborhood dogs. They don't bother me at all, so that's good. Griddle is too small for this stove. Just keep flipping stuff off. Oh, thank you. I've lost like 3 mushrooms. Sorry. I would say that they're still good, but they're probably covered in like metal filings. Welcome back. Got some new freezer butter. Mushrooms are looking pretty good. You know, for mushrooms. Some provolone. Did I eat some? No, you just get two. That is some good cheese. Should I cut that before I cut the meat, maybe? The camera's right clamped up there. That's just bourbon. You want to each have one of these? This is really big. No idea it was so big.
Does this have like hot dog buns? Bakery hot dog buns or this guy?
I thought like it just looked like a normal hoagie.
Can you see my hand next to it?
I didn't.
I should have found a banana for two.
You should have found a banana. Better.
Okay, I'm gonna go watch.
Okay. Let's cut some steak. And these guys. Turn up nice. Make sure they're in enough butter is kind of key. How's your night going, Beaker? Kind of fun. I haven't streamed in like ages. Forgot how much it feels like just like hanging out, you know. So I'm gonna have to wash my hands here. I have some water out here in my truck kitchen. Duck photos and a muskrat or two. Nice. So, I think this seems like a pretty decent steak. I have no idea how chewy it's going to be. We're just going to do, see what the grain is. I think I'm just going to do some thin cuts all the way up here. But I think just for sake of ease, I'm going for as thin as I can. Thankfully, this is a very sharp knife. Slight angle. That is not sticking together too well. I haven't touched any meat with my pinky. I'm gonna go get some hand sanitizer out of the truck here. Just a second. Just throw it down there to sizzle. Throwing it on there just purely for entertainment. Yeah, meaty hands on the Coleman. Oh, that sounds painful though. Just by placing my hands directly on the griddle. Gosh, I love having nice sharp knives. Is nice. I don't know if I'm like making a steak crime right now. I don't really know this kind of steak too well. Like off. Or can you grab some hand sanitizer from the center console to try and hold it? Yeah, if you could, that'd be awesome. Thanks. Can you just put it on the torque test, please? Is here is like not great. That's not good. We got some pictures of some ducks. That's awesome. So cool that you're into photography now. Pretty neat. I know you enjoyed taking photos before, but you're like into it now. Okay, well, that is some cut up steak. So, hand sanitize. Look awesome. Okay, are you taking that? Can you bring down another cutting board?
No,
okay, thank you. Sorry, the outdoor lights don't work right now. Deep fryer down here. There's a lot of oil that's getting trapped in this oil trap. There's butter down there. Yeah. Some searing on some of these pieces. go on some morsels. Mostly just fat that I cut off. There's some meat on there. Yum. Kind of in the home stretch here. Ice cold onion and peppers. Money Buns says, "Don't forget to toast the hoagies." Good plan, Money Buns. How are the JoJo's doing inside? Hoist the toasties. Hoist the huevos into the flauta. You warmed up, alright. Thank you, my guns. This is looking pretty solid. Pepper's got a little crunch yet. Spicy, not enough salt though. I didn't salt the onions and peppers. I'm gonna keep the Larry's train going. This is like the tricky part. We don't want to lose anything. We gotta make room to warm up the mushrooms again and to toast the hoagie. We're gonna even go down into our grease trap here. Mushrooms, we're gonna put them over here. I need help. No, it should be alright. You're almost done now. I think once this is done, we're gonna have to end the stream. too big for this bun. This bun is way too big for this stuff. Toast that hoagie. How we doing? Kind of toasted. We're gonna add some more butter to it. Because this meal needs more butter, is what it needs. Problem is the butter is frozen, so it doesn't really slather too well. It just kind of globs. Forget about the cheese, you're right. Did forget about the cheese. Now that's still hot. We've got some provolone. I'm just gonna cut the heat entirely here. Cheese out. Please, yeah. Yeah. Do you want to eat out here?
Cool.
Pretty cold. Okay. So I will get my my screw and nut kit, cut all the vegetables. Nice and toasty.
Cool.
I guess my nose is pretty cool. I'm just gonna shove everything in the garage once this is fully done and close it. Pretty good. I think that's it. You think we should just bring the whole griddle inside?
If you want, that's easier.
Let me get our... I'll put some more lights on. I think that will help significantly. Okay. Well, I think I'm going to call that an extremely long stream. So, thanks everyone for hanging out. We made dinner. Set the griddle. It was a blast. And we're gonna have some yummy dinner. Talk to you all later.